Amen, amen. Good morning. Good morning, God's Father, believers, ministers, family, and faithful. We bring you greetings from the Honorable Bishop Deriel and Lady Patrice McClendon. Here at God's Power, everybody is somebody, and Jesus is our overseer. So we invite you to open your hearts and receive what God has for you. And always remember our church scripture, Proverbs 3, verse 5, 6, and 7. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not into our own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in thy own eyes. Fear the Lord, and depart from evil. I am your MC for the day, Jessica Bridges, and I will open this up in a word of prayer. Amen. So get before him however you come before the Lord. Amen. That goes for you too on Facebook Live.
Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just come to you, Father God, as humble as we know how, giving you all the praise and giving you all the glory, because Father God, you are so worthy to be praised. Father God, thank you for life, health, and strength. Thank you for waking us up, Father God, this morning, giving us another chance to get it right, Father God, in your eyesight, Father God. Father God, thank you that we was able to drive here this morning, no matter what we went through last night, no matter what we went through this morning, but Lord, we made it in your house to give you the praise, Father God, because you that worthy, Father God. Lord, we can't thank you for everything that you have done for us, Father God, what you're doing for us, Father God, what you're going to do, Father God. Lord, we ask that you just forgive us for all our sins, Father God, known and unknown, Father God. Lord, we ask that you continue to keep your hand on us, Father God. Lord, we can ask that you continue to give us your grace and your mercy, Father God. Lord, we thank you for your grace and your mercy, because, Lord, you give it to us when we're unworthy, Father God. Lord, you love us when we don't love ourselves, Father God. Lord, we ask that you enlarge our territory, Father God. Lord, we ask that you continue to keep our bishop and our elect lady covered, Father God. Lord, we ask that our life lined up according to your will, Lord, not our will, but your will, Father God. And Lord, when we turn left, when you tell us to go right, Father God, we ask that you make every crooked path straight, Father God. Lord, continue to order our steps right now, Father God. Lord, we ask that we plead the blood of Jesus over us from the crown of our heads to the very soul of our feet, that no weapons formed against us shall prosper.
In the mighty name of
all
Jesus.
All things through Christ that strengthens us, Father God. Lord, we know that you'll never put more on us than we can bear. So, Lord, we just want to say thank you, Father God. We're going to praise you through every trial, Father God. Lord, we know that you can control the weapon in every storm, Father God. Lord, we ask that you touch everyone that's in the hospitals, Father God, everyone that's sick and shut in, Father God. Lord, we know that they are already healed by your stripes. So, Lord, we just ask that your will be done, Father God. Lord, we ask that you deliver everyone that's in the jail, Father God, a whole house, a crack house, Father God, right now, Father God. Lord, we ask that you continue to keep our unsaved loved ones, Father God, right now, Father God. Lord, we ask that your name be edified in every service that goes forth this morning, Father God. Lord, we ask that everyone make normal call, Father God. Lord, we just say thank you, Lord. Lord, we just say thank you. Lord, we thank you for our Sunday school this morning, because, Father God, we're going to stop making excuses while we don't come sit at this supper table, Father God, and talk with you, Father God. Lord, forgive us for making excuses, Father God, when you just here waiting on us, Father God. We're not waiting on you. So, Lord, we just say thank you. Lord, we say thank you. Lord, we say thank you. Lord, we say thank you. Lord, when the lights cut out, Lord, we say thank you. Lord, when we don't have food to eat, Lord, we're going to say thank you. Because, Father, y'all, we know that you'll make a way out of no way. Because, Lord, when man leave, he's still right here, Father God. You don't leave us, Father God. Lord, we say thank you. Because when our values fluctuate and men go up and down, our values still stay the same, because we are children of the Most High. So, Lord, we say thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, yes,
thank
yes.
Thank you, Lord. Bless your holy name right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I can't thank you enough, Father
yes,
God.
Yes, Father God.
Because you kept me in my right mind. When what I went through could have took me out a long time ago. But, Lord, you saw fit to not be with you. So, Lord, I can't see nothing but say thank you, Lord. I couldn't make an excuse this morning and say I was tired from work last night. Lord, I know I had to get in this house and bless your holy name because you've been that good to me, Father God. Lord, I can't do nothing but say thank you. don't know who else can say thank you this morning, but God been good to you because you woke up this morning. He started you on your way. So Lord, I say thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. The backstop is the one that smiles and laughs in my face, but talk about me behind my back, Lord. Bless them right now. Lord, peace be still. Peace be still in my home. Peace be still in my job, Father God. Peace be still in my mind, Father God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, Father God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, I give praise.
Yes,
Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We will have the praise team come up and just continue to worship the Lord on in. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. 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 I dare everybody just give God 10 seconds of praise. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Father God, you've been worthy, Father God. To us, Lord God. Father God, we thank you right now, Father God. Father God, put us in the right mindset, Father God. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for giving us to and from, Father God. Father God, thank you for the very breath that we breathe right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, thank you for your spirit manifesting itself, Lord God. Father God, we will be yielding vessels to you, Lord God. Father God, mold us and make us, shape us and form us into who you've called us to be, Father God. No more living parallel to the life that you have predestined for us to live, Lord God. Lord God, we will live the life that you have designed for us to live, Lord God. Father God, we will walk the walk. We will talk the talk. We will say what we mean and mean what we say, Father God. For you we live, for you we die alone. In Jesus' name, hallelujah, not another man will get our praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You control the weather in our storm. Peace be still, peace be still. We come in peace. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear and whom shall I be afraid of? Thank you, I walk through the valley of the shadow and death. I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff comfort me in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Have your will, Father God, and have your way. Father God, keep us past our understanding. Thank you for giving the peace that surpasses our understanding. Father God, that's carnally and flesh, we don't understand. But Father God, spiritually, Lord God, thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We just give you all the praise, God, and give you all the glory. Father God, touch those that don't understand right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, touch the ones that just don't understand right now, Father God. Father God, we just give you praise right now.
Lift your hands.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, yes, God. Thank you, Lord God. We're not going to give up. Hallelujah. We're going to keep going. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. How many that is worthy to be praised? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We finna get intimate with God. This is a surprise. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God, because we bow down, Father God. We bow to you with you alone. Hallelujah. Yes, you know this song. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Bow down and worship Him. As it reads, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is built as a city that is compact together. Whither the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, unto the testimony of Israel, to give thanks unto the name of the Lord. For there are set thrones of judgment, the thrones of the house of David. Pray for peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love thee. Peace be within thy walls, and prosperity within thy palaces. From thy brethren and companions' sake, I will now say, peace be within thee. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Deacon Myers, for our scripture this morning. And now we will have our welcome by our very own Sister Cleo, but you already should feel welcome when you walk through the door.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
It's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time, isn't it?
Amen.
I would like to welcome everybody out, including those on live stream, to God's Power and Deliverance Ministries.
Amen.
Where our main overseer is no other than Jesus Christ. Amen. And of course, our shepherd of this house is no other than our very own beloved, the Honorable Bishop Derek L. McClendon.
Amen.
And of course, our beautiful elect lady, Patrice McClendon.
Amen.
I welcome everybody out today. And all those that are on live stream, if you're new to our church, please just write your name in the chat. We welcome you with the love of Jesus. Here at GPDM, everybody is somebody. Amen. And we definitely have a special treat with a guest speaker who is no guest to us.
Amen.
But you will see that later. So, you guys just sit back, relax, make sure you have your pens and paper for a good word that's coming forth. Amen. And welcome, welcome. Everybody is welcome in the house of the Lord.
Thank you, Sister Cleo, for that welcome. And without further ado, I will be calling my mother, Mother Bridges, up to do our announcements and seed time. Amen. And if little Corey can come get the baskets, sometimes an offering as well. Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So glad to be in the house of the Lord one more time.
Amen.
I'm here to bring the announcements, and they are as follows. The next prayer line will be held on Tuesday, September the 6th at 7:30 p.m. The prayer line number is 302-202-1104, and the passcode to get on the prayer line is 223-291. Elect Lady McClendon will be ministering in Birmingham, Alabama for the Wailing Women's Conference. It's hosted by Elder Louise Gordon. She's the founder of Your Turning Point Ministries. This event will be held on Saturday, September the 10th at 1 p.m. The address is 500 Jean Reed Road, Suite 113B, and that's in Birmingham, Alabama. Stream Ministries will be presenting our annual I Am a Survivor Breast Cancer Banquet. This event will be held Saturday, October the 1st, 2022, and it's going to be in Birmingham, Alabama, also at 500 Jean Reed Road, Suite 113B. That's in Birmingham, Alabama. So please mark these dates on your calendar. Our pastoral appreciation will be held Saturday, October the 15th. That service will start at 6 o'clock on October the 16th, which is Sunday. That service will start at 2 o'clock. This is going to be our pastoral appreciation for Bishop Derek L. McClendon. It's going to be held at 137 Spring Street. This is in Jonesboro, Georgia, at the Perry Learning Center. Please keep in mind that we're going to be having a celebration in Birmingham on Sunday, November the 6th. So please mark that on your calendars as well. Join us on Facebook Live on Sunday mornings, and we do appreciate our live streamers on Facebook. And as Sister Cleo mentioned, please put your name in the chat if this is your first time worshiping with us, so that we can reach out to you to let you know that we do appreciate you worshiping with us. Every Wednesday night, we meet at 7:30 on the Zoom line. We have our Bible study. That number is 912-085-375. And the passcode to get on the line is all caps, GPDM13. We want to remind you that we still have the coin drop going on, so please bring your change out to drop it into the bucket for the corn drive. We want to say happy anniversary and happy birthday to all those celebrating in the month of September.
Amen.
Now it is seed time in God's Power and Deliverance Ministries.
Amen.
I will be coming from 2 Corinthians 9, 6 and 7 and Malachi 3, 7 through 12. And it reads, even from the days of your fathers, ye have gone from my ordinance and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, said the Lord of hosts. But ye say, wherein shall we return? Will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But ye say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings.
Yes.
Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me now herewith, said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground. Neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time of the field, said the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightsome land, said the Lord of hosts. But this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he purposes in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Now our cash app is $GPDM13. We also want to remember our bishop, Bishop Derek L. McClendon. He does not take a monthly salary. So we do show him our appreciation by giving him a love offering. So into Bishop McClendon. His cash app is 706-306-3133. Again, 706-306-3133. That's Bishop McClendon's cash app, and the church cash app is $GPDM13. Thank you. I'm going to turn it back over to Sister Jessica.
Amen. Everyone is welcome to come up. Important time of service to get some food to be fed.
Amen.
So that you can get through your week. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So I will introduce my sister, Minister Bridges, so she can come up and introduce our guest speaker this morning. Amen.
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 Amen. Everybody, let's give Sister Jessica a hand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Well, God has been so wonderful today, so far. Hallelujah. Haven't he?
Amen.
He got us this far. Amen.
Amen.
We weren't like the man at church who fell out the window, wasn't we?
No.
They ain't have to resuscitate. They ain't have to resuscitate nobody. So we good. Amen.
Amen.
This has been a life-filled service, and we just thank God for his presence. We thank God for the woman in God that's about to take this stand. Amen. We pray right now that God manifests himself into her as she is a willing vessel. We thank God for her saying yes to the assignment. We thank God that she did not give us an excuse. We thank God that she is a woman in God. We thank God that she is a wonderful wife. She is a wonderful mother. She is a wonderful spiritual mother. And Lord God, she said something that touched me. Delayed obedience is still disobedience. So I thank God that she said what she said, because it gets me off my feet. Amen. Amen. And I pray that it gets you all off yours, Lord God. So we just thank God for Elder Selma Smith.
gotta press sometimes. Oh, I just come to stand before you just to proclaim, I know we talked about it this morning, but church is my college. Heaven is my university. Father God is my counselor. And Jesus is my principal. The Holy Spirit is my teacher. Angels are my classmates. And the Bible is my textbook. Temptations are my exams. Overcoming Satan is my hobby. That's a hobby. You got to do that every day. But winning souls for Jesus is my assignment. We all got an assignment. That's what I want you to know. And receiving eternal life is my degree. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I come before you this morning in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I am the Reverend Selma D. Smith, a servant of God, called from my sleep, awakened to the voice of God, just to get to know him, to be an example of God's word for those who need to know a loving God, a merciful God, a God that will accept you, approve you, forgive you, and love you. I am Reverend Selma Smith. Let us pray. Father God, it's in the name of your son, Jesus, that we bow down before you once more and again. Lord, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for this day, God, because truly this is a day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you for life, health, and strength. Thank you for allowing each and every one of us to be here to worship and to fellowship one more time in your name, Heavenly Father. Oh, God, it's all because of your grace and mercy. We didn't have to be here, but you allowed our moments to roll on just a little while longer because you loved us just that much. And so, God, we just say thank you. Heavenly Father, we ask that you will bless the sick. Bless those who are bereaved, even those who are in prison. Someone on the street don't know you in the pardon of their sins, Heavenly Father. And then, God, we ask that you will forgive us. Forgive us of our sins, something that we might have said, something that we might have done, a way we could have looked, Heavenly Father, that was not pleasing in your sight. So create within us a clean heart.
Yeah,
renew within us a right spirit, Heavenly Father. God, we just say thank you this morning. We just love you, God. We just came to give you glory because all praise belongs to you. You are the creator and the sustainer of the universe. So God, we love you. And we thank you for your son, Jesus. If it had not been for the blood of Jesus, if it had not Jesus going to the cross, Heavenly Father, oh my God, we don't know where we would be. But we thank you, God. We honor you, God. We give you praise, and it is in the matchless and mighty name of Jesus the Christ, God. We say amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
We give honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is truly the head of each and every one of our lives. And then to my Father in the ministry, to Bishop Derek McClendon, elect lady Patrice McClendon. I thank God that he allowed me to be here this morning. He called and said, Elder, I said, yes, Bishop. He said, I need you this morning. I said, my God, it's good to feel needed. It's good to feel wanted. And I am so grateful to be among family and friends once again. So I thank God and I thank him for the opportunity. I will try not to be before you long. That was one of my favorite praise and worship songs. I play it in the morning time. I play it in the car when I'm at work and, you know, some hard days are going on and some things are happening. You know, you need a little boost every now and then. And I have some certain songs that I just click on and I play. So I just tell the Lord, thank you. We got to fight on.
Amen.
We're living in perilous times. We're living in hard times. We got to learn how to press. We got to learn how to press because Jesus said the battle has already been won. It's already been won. It's already been fought. The victory is ours. We have the victory, people. We have the victory. But it's a process that we have to go through. So I thank God that we have the victory. My scripture is coming this morning from Romans 8, 14 through 17. That's Romans 8, 14 through 17. And it says, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage, again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father.
Yes.
The spirit itself bear witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be glorified together. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. I just come to talk a little bit about all in the family. It's all in the family. We're a family, GP Ministry. You all are a family, but we are a family. And because we are a family, if we know Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, we are in God's family. Amen?
Amen.
So we are family. Listen, I thought that life would be easy. Once I received Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior, once I became a part of God's family, and I expected everything to be smooth. I expected to be walking on straight street, you know, just having a good time, enjoying life, but devoting myself to the Lord. But however, that's not what I found out. That's not what the scripture showed me. Little did I know that being saved is where my problems first begin. They begin to increase. When I start talking about Jesus, friends began to walk away. When I start talking about Jesus, they said, who do you think you are? When I start talking about Jesus, even in my family and in my own home, they begin to act strange. You know what I'm talking about? Oh, it's as if I had lost my mind or lost reality, as if I had lost touch with what was going on. Folks just couldn't understand. They didn't understand me anymore. They said, you seem different. You're not the same person that you used to be. I don't know what's going on with you. But you know, we can't hang with you no more. Now we can't do things no more. And I said, okay. But the new life that I received with Jesus gave me happiness. See, Paul was also a man who the Lord used. And yet his life was anything compared to easy. In fact, he had pain. He had sorrow. It was too much for him to bear. But there was nothing wrong with him asking God to deliver him from his suffering. Remember, he asked Jesus 3 times. You know what I'm saying? Can you remove this thorn? He was shipwrecked. He was beaten. He was thrown into prison. He was writing from the prison to the churches. He was still serving God. And he said, can you remove this thorn? But you know what God said? He said, my grace is sufficient. He said, I am making provision even in the midst of the sorrow and the pain that you're going through. So his life was on point. And I said it to you, whatever assignment God gives you, that assignment is for you. God has purposed and ordained each and every one of us to receive an assignment. And that assignment has been ordained just for you. So don't make an excuse, God, I can't do this. Oh, don't be like Moses said, I got a speech stutter. I can't get my words out straight. You know, I'm afraid. Yeah, but you know what fear is? Fear is facing everything and recovering. Fear is false evidence appearing real. And God has not given us a spirit of fear, but he has given us a power of what? Love and a sound mind.
Amen.
So his goal is to develop us in spiritual growth. His goal is to make us characters like Jesus Christ, to be strong in faith. Our trials play a role in achieving our gospel mission. All believers are in a partnership with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. See, families today don't look like the traditional families when I was coming along. Oh, I can think back and I remember when I was younger and I was growing up, we were taught love. We were taught values, morals, discipline, and respect. Our parents instilled it in us. You know what? If my mama was talking and I had something to say and she looked at me a certain way, I better sit down and wait. Because what I had to say wasn't important. When they're talking, you say, excuse me. You know, you say, thank you. You say, please. My mom was the first lady, but she was a missionary. And she would go to the mother's house on Saturday and clean up, and she would take us with her. And mama would say, let me tell you something before we get here. Don't act like you ain't got no home training. She said, you better know who your parents are. Mama was saying, don't get over here and act like you're hungry, because I fed you before you left home. There were times that they were offering, you know, want to give you something, and mama would say, it's okay. But my mama had a certain look. My mama had a certain disposition about herself that I knew she wasn't playing. And I knew that my mom meant business. My mom is a mother of 9, and I'm the last of the 9 generations. And they say I get away with a lot of things, but I don't believe so. But I just want you to know, mama didn't play back in the day. Our parents taught us. You know, and just to know that we got all kind of kin folks. We got all kind of people in our DNA. See, today we got diverse families. We got blended families. We got multiracial families. We got single parent families. We got grandparent families. We have adopted families. And we still got baby mama drama families. Don't act like it ain't going on. Oh yeah, it's going on in the world today. See, we have to examine our lives so that they can look apart from the lives of the world. He said, we're in this world, but we're not of this world. So we're in this world because we have to live here. We're in this world because this is a place that he has prepared for us. But we can't act like the people in the world. If I say I'm saved and I'm a Christian, I can't act like they're acting outside the door. I can't go to the club and shake it all night and then walk up in here acting like I'm somebody and Jesus trying to tell you about yourself. I can't act like I'm saved in church and then get out there and cuss you out in the parking lot. No, that's not what the word of God says. So let me tell you something about this family of God. There's just three nuggets that I want to share with you. First of all, the children of God, they resemble God. And then secondly, we have been adopted into God's family. And then third, if we have been adopted into God's family, we are heirs of God. And when I say the children of God resemble God, listen, it said believers are led by the Spirit. We are to have confidence in God's truth. We are to rely on God's provision. We don't need proof because the Bible is everything we need. He has given us 66 books, and in His Word, we can find all truth because His Word does not lie.
Amen.
Genesis 1 and 2, it said the Spirit of God moved among the surface. You know, we didn't see the Spirit of God moving, but we believe that the Spirit of God moved. Why? Because we saw the results of the Spirit of God moving. When the wind blows, you don't know where the wind is coming from. You don't know which direction it's going in, but you know the wind is blowing. And then He said in Ezekiel, He said, I will put My Spirit within you and cause you to walk in My statutes and in My ways. And you will be careful to observe My law. See, God has placed His Spirit down on the inside of us, people of God. And because His Spirit is in us, we are led to be sons and daughters of God. The Spirit of God is on the inside of us. And God said, what is on the inside is going to show up on the outside. That's why He said, I see the heart of man. God looks at the heart. Man sees the outside. And you can see filthy rags on the outside. You can see a messed up person on the outside. You can see an ugly person. That's what you'll say. But God sees the inside. He knows securities. He knows simply what you mean and what you want to say and what you're going to do. God knows the spirit. God knows the inside of man. And so He said, and Ezekiel said, I will put My Spirit in you and you will come to life. He said, God has breathed on us. See, the very breath that we breathe is God's breath. He has breathed on us. He's breathed His Spirit within us. You remember in Genesis, it said that God created us in His image. God stooped down in the clay and He began to draw in the clay and He formed us in the image and the likeness that He wanted us to be. We are made different from every other animal, every other creature that God has created. Animals have four legs. God has given us two. Two hands, two feet, two legs. You know what I'm saying? Two eyes, two ears, one nose, one mouth. Don't even one mouth because this little bit of tongue right here can cause so much damage. Mm-hmm. But He created us in His image and His likeness. And then God was so amazed that He did what? He blew into us His breath of life. And we became a living soul. We're not living on our own. We're living because of His breath that is moving on the inside of us. See, He took that clay and He had to resuscitate that clay. Just like He told Ezekiel, can these bones live? What He said? He said, Lord God, only You know. He said, only You know that these bones can live. And God said, speak to him.
Come on now.
He spoke to him.
Command the wind.
And the bones began to come back together. But it was the Word of God. It was the Spirit of God. So with the Spirit of God, we are obedient to the Word of God. And so, how are we obedient to the Word of God? We must be willing to hear the Word of God. We must be willing to receive and obey the Word of God. We have to hear the Word of God with instructions. We have to comply and submit to the authority of God. Yes, you can read the Word, but He says, study. Study to show thyself approval of workmen that needed not be ashamed. Rightly dividing the Word of truth. You got to rightly divide it. See, I can read Scripture. And I can think it means one thing. When I began to study and ask the Holy Spirit, I began to ask God, and He gives me the interpretation of what He wants the Word to be, what He desires for me to do. And so when we have the Spirit of God, we have to accept His Word, His Son, who is none other than Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. So that's how we have a relationship with God the Father. We are connected to God. We are associated and we are involved with God. So we have to do the things that pleases God. God just wants us to be obedient. He just wants us to obey. He said, I'll give you the desires of your heart. But He wants us to be obedient. He wants us to commune with Him every day, to communicate with Him. Lord, what it is that You desire of me? What it is that You want me to do? I've gotten to the point where I look in the mirror and I say, God, how do I look today? What is it You want me to wear today? What can I do today? You know, we have to consult God about everything. Lord, I got a situation going on. I know You already know about it, but how You want me to answer today? I got a meeting I got to sit in on today. I got some questions that's been asked. Give me the answers. Tell me how to act. Show me what You want me to do when I get in there. Sometimes God will say, be silent. And then sometimes God will give you what He wants you to say. Because sometimes it's just foolishness. Foolishness sometimes. A lot of times we deal with things on the job that are just foolishness. And it's just because of the people who are in authority and the people who are in charge of the positions and the jobs that we have. And so then we become children of God. So we are free to believe. Free to believe what? We are free to believe that we are no longer in bondage, that no more spirit of bondage. You know why? Because no longer enslaved to sin. We were once held in captivity. We were once enslaved because of what? Our beliefs. We were once enslaved because we were born in sin. We were formed in sin. But we have beliefs now. Our religion. Anyone who is a follower of the way, anyone who is a follower of Christ, has established that there is a relationship. There is Christianity. See, God's people were suppressed. They were depressed. They were deprived. They were oppressed. They were restricted. And they were even killed for speaking of Jesus back in the day, by the way. But we no longer have to fear death. We no longer have to fear a burning hell and a sinner's death, because the Lamb of God, who is Jesus, has taken away the sin of the world. He has freed us. He has paid the penalty for our sin. And so, I don't know about you, but that's good news right there. That's good news to know that the penalty has been paid. We couldn't do it ourselves. He said, I searched all over. Looked high and low. Couldn't find nobody. There were some righteous men, but they weren't righteous enough. He couldn't find nobody. So what did Jesus say? He said, I'll go myself. He disrobed himself. He was sitting on the right hand of the Father. He was in the Holy of Holies, but he disrobed himself. And he came down to earth and walked among men so that he would show us, so that he would teach us, so that we would know there is nothing that we have to go through. There is nothing that we have to deal with that he has already not gone through and paid the consequences for that sin. We serve a great God. We can praise God for ourselves. We can lift our hands. We no longer have to be told in church, you come on and give God some praise. No, you ought to come in here clapping your hands. You ought to come in here praising God. You ought to come in here shouting hallelujah. He woke you up. He clothed you in your right mind. And you are here today because of him, his grace and his mercy. Ain't nobody got to tell you to praise God. You ought to want to praise God.
Amen.
Demonstrate your love for Christ in your own way. There are a lot of different ways. I know the younger people have a way that they praise God, and we have a way that we praise God. But as long as God gets the praise, as long as God gets the glory, because it's all about him. It is for him to get the praise alone. I take none of his glory. Everything I do, I say, thank you, God. Somebody give me a compliment, I say, thank you, but it was him. It was him. It was God. He gave me the answer that I needed. He shared that information with you. He gave me the power and the strength to pray for you. He anointed me to help you and to bless you. It was God. I can do nothing on my own. See, we are nothing without him. But through him, we have the power. All things are possible. So the spirit of adoption, when you receive the spirit of adoption, you must have Jesus in your life as your personal Lord and Savior. Jesus gives us access to the Father. See, in order to get to the Father, we must go through the Son. There is no alternate. He has given all power and authority to his Son, Jesus Christ. And in order to get to the Father, we must go through the Son. When you receive Jesus, that's a wonderful gift. Oh my God. It is a wonderful gift to receive Jesus. When you have Jesus and you accept Jesus, then guess what? The Father accepts you. The Father accepts us. When we have a relationship with the Son, then the Father accepts us. And when we accept Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that's our passport. That's access right there. I don't know about you, but I'm glad I had an opportunity to meet Jesus for myself. I'm glad I had an opportunity to know him for myself, to get to know him, to understand him, so that he can understand me, so that he can help me. So we're adopted into the family. Once we have a relationship with Jesus and we have accepted him as our personal Lord and Savior, then the Father accepts us. And then if we are God's children, then we are his heirs. We are heirs of God. So what is an heir? As a person that inherited something. You have no rights to the inheritance, but somebody left it for you. Somebody gave it to you. We have a promise. Someone made us a promise. When your ancestors were alive, even when your grandmama and them leave, sometimes they always leave you a little something. And I say all the time that I want minds to know God for themselves. Yes, I want to leave a legacy. Yes, I want you to have some things, but I want you to know the man for yourself. I want you to know that when I'm dead and gone and when I can't answer questions and when you can't find a way for yourself, it is Jesus that you need in your life. He is the answer to all of our problems. He is the solution. What the world needs now is Jesus, an answer to every question is Jesus. It might be property, it might be finance, but whatever that blessing is, you didn't work for it. And that's the grace that we have. That's the grace that we have by Jesus Christ. We didn't work for it. It's that for by grace we have been saved through faith. And it is not of ourselves, it is a gift. A gift that comes from God. He loved us so much. He thought so much of us. And it talks about it in Psalms 8. It said, what is man? The angel said, God, what is man that you so desire him? What is about this man that you love him so much? God loves us and he desires us. He wants a relationship with us. So listen, we've been adopted into the family. We are heirs of God and Jesus Christ. So what did Jesus inherit? Jesus inherited everything that his father had. Jesus inherited his father's name. Jesus inherited all of the benefits from the father. Listen and say, in the beginning, God created. In the beginning, God stepped out on nothing and he spoke everything into existence. God made everything. And then it says in John, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God, and the same that was in the beginning. So Jesus was with God from the very beginning. So he has inherited everything that the Father has. He has all benefits that the Father has. And it was not by accident or circumstance that he had been given the power in his hand. God gave it to him. God gave an inheritance. Just like I talked about leaving an inheritance, he gave an inheritance to us. Because we are heirs. So God gave it to Jesus the Son. Jesus the Son gave us a portion of that inheritance. He inherited everything once he went to the cross, once he died. Jesus is the living hope. Jesus is the living glory. Jesus is everything that we need. So the blessings of God are unconditional. We have comfort in God. We have peace in God. He made provision for us here on earth. That's the peace that we have. That's the prosperity that we have. He said, in this world, you're going to have trials and tribulations. But what did he say? He said, but be of good cheer, because I have overcome the world. He said, I'm going to give you a peace. That's the passage all understanding. A peace that the world won't understand. Peace is shalom. There's nothing missing, nothing broken, everything whole. When you are in Jesus Christ, he gives us that peace. And guess what he gives us? He gives us guidance. His presence is always with us. His presence is always near us. We can just reach out and call on his name. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. I will be with you always, even unto the end of the world. So as joint heirs with Christ, he's given us some benefits. The benefits that he gave to Jesus. And because he gave those benefits to his son Jesus, Jesus passed those benefits on to us. So what is it that Jesus had, that we have? Well, Jesus is love. And he gave us love. He gave us that agape love. That love beyond reason. See, when a person acts in love, you can't look at the circumstance what the person is doing. You can't look at the way that the person is acting. You got to see beyond it, because that is a spirit. Amen. You know, when people are acting out and even in our own homes or whatever is going on, that is a spirit within that person. That's not the person. So you got to look beyond that. He has given us agape love. He has given us peace. He has given us unconditional love. And he has made comfort for us. God provides for us each and every day. We have jobs that we are able to go to. We can provide for our families. Our kids can go to school, you know, so they can learn an education. And then as parents, we motivate them. We encourage them. We push them to do a little bit more. You know, I didn't have all the access that you have, sons. I want you to do this. Daughter, I want you to be somebody. I want you to make it. God has so much for you that all you got to do is reach up and grab it. When you reach up and pull your blessings down, when the praises go up, then the blessings come down. He begins to bless us over and over and over and over and more again and again. Unlike Jesus, who is perfect, we are not perfect. We are near perfect. But God, who is so patient with us, he gives us chance after chance after chance. God loves us so much that what did he say? When we fall short, we got to get up. When we sin, we got to acknowledge that we have done wrong, ask for forgiveness, and we have to turn. We can't turn and go the same 380. We got to go 320. We got to go half of that. Because if you keep going around and around, you're going to be going in the same direction. But if you turn halfway and make a stop and say, God, what is it that I can do, then he'll correct your path. He'll direct your path. He said, trust in me with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. But in all your ways, if you acknowledge me, he said, I'll direct your path. He's going to put you on the path that he wants you to be on, that path, the straight street. See, the roads are crooked sometimes, but he makes the path straight. He's our GPS. He's our navigation system. He works on our behalf. So now that you understand that you have benefits and you have received the gift of being adopted into God's family, I also want you to know and understand what the Bible says. The Bible says, if so be that we suffer with Christ, that we may also be glorified with him. Scripture teaches us that we have our own cross to bear. And if Jesus suffered, why can't we? He said, if any man want to be my disciple, he said, you got to pick up your cross and you got to follow me. He didn't promise us that life would be easy. He said, there's some hardships you're going to go through. There's some ups, there's some downs, there's some hurt, and there's some pain. But if we suffer with Jesus, he won't leave us. He died for each and every one of us. So people of God, I want you to understand. See, in this wicked and evil world that we live in this mean world that we live in, every day won't be a bed of roses. Every day there won't be sunshine. But there will be some rain. There will be some clouds. There will be some heartaches. There will be some grief. There will be some uncomfortable trials, tragedies, and tribulations that we have to face. But just know that you're not alone. Just know that you're not on this journey by yourself. See, it's an uphill journey, and you got to keep climbing. You got to climb higher mountains just to get home. You got to keep struggling. You got to keep striving. But you are not alone. But you got to stay true to God. You got to stay true to his word. So things that are happening, don't let it upset you. It bothers us. Oh, yeah, I think about a lot of things that go on. I think about the hardship in the world. Mississippi over there don't have any water. We can't survive without water. Water is life. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. I am the living water. He said, he that thirsts, if you drink this water, you'll never thirst again. He is the living water. But he also said that I am here for you. We have to learn how to cry out to God. We have to learn how to call on God. He said that if you call on me, that I will answer. I will show you great and mighty things. He said, seek me. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto it. He said, ask and it shall be given unto you. He said, knock and the door shall be opened. That's what he said. Oh, but I came to tell you a little bit of good news. See, the Bible says that if we suffer with him, then we shall be glorified with him. Amen. See, one glad morning when this life is over. I don't know about you, but I want to leave this mean old world. I want to go and spend eternity with my Father, the one who died for me. I want to see him for myself. Job said that I know that my Redeemer lives, and he shall stand at the latter days, and I shall see him for myself. I shall see him and not another. I want to see Jesus for myself. I want to see the one who died for me, the one who bled for me, the one who suffered for me, the one who loved me so much that he gave me another chance. He said that we have mansions in heaven with our name on it. What did he say? He said, in my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And as I go, I'm going to come back and I'm going to receive you unto myself, just like I told you. He said that we will have a glorified body. He said that we are going to be renewed. We are going to be made whole. We are going to have life everlasting. We are going to have eternity. He said, I'm going to give you beauty for your ashes. Some of us have had some trials. Some of us have had some tragedies. Some of us have been burned and scorched in the fire. But he said, I'm going to give you beauty for your ashes. He said, I'm going to give you the oil of joy. I'm going to give you a praise garment that you can praise me forever. He said, two wings to veil your face. Two wings to veil your feet. Two wings to fly away. And this old world can't do you any harm. See, Jesus is our chief landlord and keeper. We'll be waiting to receive that home that he has for us. He's a mighty God. He's a great God. He is a good listener. And just because you see me going through, you don't know the situation, you don't know the circumstance, but I'm going through. And it's okay. It's all right, because we got to go through. See, my situation might not look like yours, and yours might not look like mine. We got trouble on every side. We got trouble in the front. We got trouble in the back. The winds are bouncing. They're moving to and fro. The storms of life are raging. But when you get one of those storms worked out, it's nobody but the Lord who does it. He gives you a hit. He gives you a home run. See, I'm going to keep my head up. I'm going to walk boldly in the name of Jesus. I'm going to stick my chest out. See, I'm not going to look down on my sister or my brother, because he sent me here to help somebody. He sent me here for a purpose and for a reason. See, there's some things that are happening in my life, and I see some things that are going on with you that I might be able to help you. I might be able to share a kind word. I might be able to do something to help you as I pass along the way. You don't know how God is going to come. Sometimes when you're entertaining strangers, they might be an angel that God has sent just to see how you're going to act, just to see how you're going to respond. See, we should be praying for one another. You know, midnight comes and it rains in each of our lives, you know, but I want you to know that there is a way out. There is a God. See, we got to stay prayed up. We got to stay tied up, tangled up in Jesus, in the word of Jesus. We got to learn to walk by the word, to live by the word, to talk by the word, to eat by the word, to pray the word. To pray the word of God, because Jesus never fails. He's a way maker. He's a miracle worker. He's a promise keeper. He's a light in the darkness. Oh, I can call him anytime, any place, and anywhere. If you call on him, he'll answer. If you need him, he is right there by your side. Oh, I love the Lord because he heard my cry. And he pitied my every groan. And as long as I live and troubles rise, I'm going to hasten to his throne. See, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scorn. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in that law does he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth fruit in his season. Oh, I don't know about you, but I want to be like that tree. That tree that has said, I shall not be moved. You might reel and you might rock. You might fall forward and you might go backwards. But that tree is standing still, because that tree is planted on solid ground. That tree is planted. You remember what Jesus talked about? The ones who build his house, one build his house on sand, but the other one builds his house on a rock. That rock is Jesus. Oh, Christ, the solid rock I stand. No other ground but sinking sand. I'm going to build my house on that rock. Amen. You got to be like that tree planted by the rivers of water. No matter what come, no matter what way, you're going to stand. You're going to stand for Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, you got to stand for Jesus. If you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. But I'd rather stand for Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, because I know that he hears. And he answers my call. I don't know about you, but stop making excuses. We have no excuses. You talked about it this morning. Don't make excuses. Because God said, if you be ashamed to own me before men, I'll be ashamed to own you before my Father, which is in heaven. He said, many of us are going to get up there and go to the door. We're going to knock. Jesus, he's going to say, I know you're not. What did you do for me? Did you feed the hungry? Did you clothe the naked? Did you give them shelter when they need it? Who did you help as you passed along this way? Oh, we're on a kingdom assignment. We're on a kingdom journey. We're on an assignment, and each of us are here to tell somebody about the Lord and Savior that we serve. Tell somebody about Jesus. Oh, there's no other name than the name of Jesus. There's no other than Jesus Christ himself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You got to stand. You got to stand. You got to be like that tree. Be like that tree. You're going to reel and you're going to rock. You're going to move and you're going to shake. But that tree, it waves back and forth. That tree. Oh, my God. Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah. He got you. You're rooted and grounded in the word of God. Hallelujah, people of God. Hallelujah, people of God. Thank God for the word of God. Hallelujah. I just came to tell you about the God I serve. I just came to tell you about Jesus. Oh, I don't know about you, but I feel good in my sanctified soul. I know that the Lord has given me a word for his people, and not just for you, but for me. Because when you leave here and go out those doors, you got to tell somebody about Jesus. You don't know who you're going to meet down the road. You don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. But be able to share the word of God. And tell somebody about Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Come on and give the Lord some praise. Come on and give the Lord some praise. Come on and give the Lord some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, people of God. People of God, we're going to prepare. Prepare for communion. Is there anything? Prepare for communion.
Missionary Jackson
is going to
come forth.
Hallelujah. Come on, missionary. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.